Thank you. So before we start this topic, we need to know something about this. Sri Sri Vilapa Pushpanjali, the name, it's showing so many things. It's giving us so many knowledges about our mood, how to attain, how to achieve that prema in our life. एंड द मेन इज उत्कंठा, अटेंशन, फोकस एंड क्राइंग. Not externally, we have to cry from our inside to achieve that prema for our bhajan. And that all lamentation, bilapa, you cannot just explain this word bilapa in this term of lamentation. No, it is not really lamentation. All the words with tears, that tears for viraha, separation, mood of separation, and that separation mood appeared for very deep and high love, strong attachment with Srimati Radharani. That attachment is not for Krishna. Who is crying here? Dash Goswami, Raghunath Dash Goswami. So, there is a question. What that? Because we know who is Dash Goswami? He is Rati Manjari, Tulasi Manjari. Isn't it? And also we know that Tulasi Manjari is the most nearest one of Srimati Radharani. Most nearest one of Srimati Radharani. A very intimate Sakhi. There is five category of Sakhis. Of Srimati Radharani, we know that. Sakhi. Priya Sakhi, Parama Prishta Sakhi. And Nitya Sakhi, Prana Sakhi. Only these two categories, Nitya Sakhi and Prana Sakhi, they are known as Manjari. For what? Because the Sakhis, like Dhanishta, they have their mood which is attached with Krishna. Yes, they are Sakhis of Srimati Radharani. But they have separate love for Krishna. Krishna Snehadika Prati. So in their heart that mood is strong. Krishna Snehadika. They love Srimati Radharani. But their love also sided to Krishna. Priya Sakhi, Parama Prishta Sakhi. They have samasneha. Same love for Srimati Radharani and Krishna. But they have also sometimes this mood will appear. They are keeping, hiding some love for Krishna. They known as samasnehadika, that means same love. Their love is same for Srimati Radharani and Sri Govinda. Lalita, Vishakha, Astashakhi, they are samasnehadika. But Prana Sakhi and Nitya Sakhi, they have very different mood. They have love only for Srimati Radharani. Their mood, they explain their mood by the words. আমার ঈশ্বরী হন বৃন্দাবনেশ্বরী, তার প্রাণনাথ বলি ভজে গিরিধারী। no attachment. I have no desire to worship Krishna. They say is, we are really attached with love for Srimati Radharani. Our love is only for Srimati Radharani. There is no place for Krishna. Then why you are serving Sri Krishna? Because Sri Krishna is Pranapati of our Ishwari, Vrindavaneshwari. She loves him. So that's why we are following the words and desire of Srimati Radharani. We have no separate love or desire for Sri Krishna. They are known as Manjari. So, Tulasi Manjari, Rati Manjari, she is already very intimate. Then why she is lamenting? Why Bilap Kusumanjali? Because we know where Srimati Radharani, that is Tulasi Manjari, Rati Manjari. By their character, what is described in the different scriptures, different books. So it is said that Tulasi Manjari, amongst all the Manjaris, she is more intimate. Antaranga. So she knows how to manage all the mood of Srimati Radharani, how to serve Srimati Radharani. Later will come the Leelas. So always she is together with Srimati Radharani. So why Bilap Kusumanjali? Then why she is lamenting?
For us.
To teach us, we have to grow our love, our bhakti in that way. Bilap is not only lamentation, it's expression, it's showing love for Srimati Radharani, especially. That's why it's compared with the flowers, all the words. In two places, we can see something different. In Rasa Leela, when Sri Krishna disappeared from Rasa Mandali, so all the Brajgopis, they start to cry. And they express their love to Krishna. But we are saying that is not crying, we are saying that is Giti, Gopi Giti. They were not crying, they were singing. Why? Because all those words, what they said that time, it was expressing their love for Krishna. And it was very deep. So that's why it was Gitika, they were singing. And here, what Rati Manjari, Tulasi Manjari, she said here in this book, all the words also is showing her love to Srimati Radharani. There is two parts. In one form, we know Raghunath Das Goswami is Rati Manjari. But now, when he is expressing that mood, he is in sadhaka form. Because Krishna is not here, Supreme Ishwar. Krishna, he himself appeared in this Kali Yuga as bhakta, as sadhaka. Kalur prachanna avatara. He himself Krishna, but he is also singing Krishna, Krishna Nama. So he appeared to teach us sadhana, bhajana. So Raghunath Das Goswami, in the mood of sadhaka, he is crying to attain that seva, but at the same time he remembered his previous form, Tulasi Manjari, Rati Manjari. That's why all the prayer here, from Manjari, Tulasi Manjari, not as Raghunath Das Goswami. In the sight of sadhaka, that is Bilapa, and from the sight of as a Manjari, it's showing her love to Srimati Radharani. So, in the same time, the true mood is appearing from Raghunath Das Goswami. He is not there, so the viraha, the separation, mood of separation appeared in the heart of Raghunath Das Goswami, where Tulasi Manjari is there, in sight of him. So then he is turned to offer his and her puja to the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani, but to do puja we need flowers. To do puja, we need flowers, sandal pearl, so many things, lamps, karpur, so many things we needed. But when one sadhaka is doing his sadhana, there is nothing, no flowers. But he has to do puja. How he will offer his puja to the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani? Kusumanjali, that bilala, that cry. By the words, all the words. So what is there? Sandal pulp? Chandan? What is chandan there? That love. Prem, anurag. All the words for Srimati Radharani is flowers. Very deep love for Srimati Radharani is chandan there. There is also everything. Not only flowers, not only chandan, also lamp. What is that lamp? Chetana. The pure knowledge of his swarup and Srimati Radharani swarup, their attachment, that knowledge, that jnana is lamp for arati, and that attachment is dhupa, which is giving smell to Srimati Radharani. So everything is there in his heart, in her heart, of Manjari and sadhaka. To realize this, before we have to know something. Manjari Bhav Sadhana. What is Manjari Bhav Sadhana? Before Manjari Bhav Sadhana. So just today morning, we are talking, Radhikaji was there. Yes, Srutidhar also was there. They are discussing. I was just listening. The point was, sadhan bhajan, we are saying sadhan bhajan. So, what is the difference between sadhan and bhajan? Is it same word? We are saying two times. So, Radhika ji, ye Shruti ke sath वो बात हो रहा था. She was talking with Srutidhar. Srutidhar said, both are the same word. What is sadhana? That is bhajan. तो राधिका जी said, no. हिंदी में बोल रहे थे, जो साध्य है वो साधन है. जो साध्य है वो है साधन। तो आई वॉज देयर इन द टॉयलेट व्हेन आई कम आउट द आसन, सो निरंजन आसन। व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन साधन एंड भजन? व्हाट राधिका जी से, राधिका जी से जो साध्य है वो साधन है, करेक्ट। इन आवर भजन, इन आवर प्रैक्टिस देयर इज टू पार्ट and it was very clear in Rai Ramananda Sambhad, sadhana bhakti, in sadhana bhakti that is also two part, vaidhi and raganuga. Our bhajan known as raganuga bhajan, but in that bhajan that is two part, Vaidhi and Raganuga. Vaidhi means we are following the rules and regulation. We are practicing, we are chanting Harinam, we are chanting the mantras, we are meditating Leelas, we are doing puja, we are serving the deities. Everything is the part of our Vaidhi Bhakti practice stage. It's known as sadhana. Or bhajan. What is bhajan? Which is when by this practice, external practice, by all those external practice, when our mind and heart will engage with that. When that ruchi, that stage will appear in front of us. We are saying we are following Raganuga Bhakti, but it's really not so easy. Shraddha, Sadhu, Sangha, Bhajana Kriya, Anartha Nivritti, Nishtha, Ruchi, then Asakti. Many stages are there. Ruchi got little bit taste from our bhajan, from our practice. Then the desire will grow. Oh, it's very tasty. Our nature, nalpe sukham asti bhumaiva sukham. When we get something very good, very tasty, we want one. Always we want more. Give me something more. So it's our nature. We are not really satisfied with little, small. We want more, big. So in the mood of their bhajan, when that will start, from where that thrust will appear, that point known as ruchi. And from ruchi it will develop asakti. From asakti our bhajan will start. From asakti stage, when we'll realize that attachment for Sri Radha Govinda, then our bhajan will start. And when our asakti will appear only for Srimati Radharani, when we'll realize that we must be attentive to Srimati Radharani, we are the servant of her, that time our Raganuga bhajan will start. So everything, bhajan, when it is coming from heart, inside, from inside, that is bhajan. Before the practice stage, that is Vaidhi Bhakti. Then by Vaidhi Bhakti, it will drive into Raganuga Bhakti. And then we need nothing. If we'll follow all the biography of our Siddha Mahatmas, before, at the beginning of their life, all of them, they also did Vigraha Seva and so many things. But after that Vigraha, which Vigraha was worshipped whole life by them, they offered it to their disciple. Why? Because that time that deity also was extra for them. They got their deity inside. So external deities are not so important for them. Yes, they have loved their deity. They have love for their deity. But to worship them, to offer them, what Loknath Prabhu, he did in his life. We know, we are there in Umrai. From Kishori Kunda, he found Radha Vinod. So when he found that deity, he was in problem. Oh, how I will worship them. Because I am living under the tree. So he put the deities on the tree. There is one big hole on the tree. So he put the deities there and he is offering only water. He started to offer only water. He said, I have only this water. So you must be satisfied with this water. I will not ask more for you. Radha Vinod Lal Ji was satisfied by this water. Sanatana Goswami Pada, his deity was Radha Madan Mohan. But one day, when it happened, that Madan Mohan said, hey Sanatana, there is no salt in the chapati. You must put some salt, you must arrange some salt. Sanatana Goswami was angry. Oh, now I have to arrange salt for you. Then next day you will ask for sweet, then some mosaji. From where will arrange this salt? You should go to other devotee and you can arrange. So Madan Mohan himself he arranged his salt. We know that story. So when sadhaka will enter in Raganga Bhajan, the deity seva, the external practices are not so important for them. Sometimes they are continuing. What in Srimad Bhagavat it said, Atma Ramushcha Munayo Nirgantha Purukrame Kurvan Tahai Tukin Bhaktim Ittam Bhuta Gunahari. When one will attain that stage, when one sadhaka becomes Atma Rama, he need nothing. Because already all the ananda, all the sukh, happiness is inside there. And he can enjoy with that. That pleasure, that bliss, that happiness is enough, more than enough for him. So external, all the practices are not so important that time. Then also, they are continuing. Actually, it is not they are continuing, it is happening automatically. After that also. Kurvan tahitukim bhaktim ittham bhuta gunamari. So it is already automatically happening with them. Tongue always chanting Mahamantra. Ear always listening Harikatha. Mind always want Bhakta Sangha, Vaishnava Sangha. So it's automatically happening. They have not to do this all. So that stage, to attain that stage, to achieve that stage, we have to follow this all. We have to attain all the parts, all the steps. then it will be ragatmika bhakti. Then it will be ragatmika bhakti. What is raga? What it is said? So, virajanti abhivyaktam brajvasi janadishu ragatmikam anusrita yasa raganuchyate. What is raganuga bhajan? What Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu says? Virajanti abhivyaktam brajvasi janadishu. What is there in the heart of all near associates of Sri Krishna Srimati Radharani? Which book is there in their heart? When in the heart of sadhaka, that desire will appear, lobha, greed will appear. Oh, I have this mood. When that mood will appear, after asakti. At the beginning, that raga, that prema, nothing will be there in the heart of sadhaka. Is not that? So first we have to pure our mind, our heart, our intelligence, our knowledge, everything. First we have to pure, make pure. How? First, most important is Guru Kripa. If he can surrender unconditionally to the lotus feet of Sri Guru, then by the Guru mercy, everything will happen. But we cannot do that unconditional surrender to the lotus feet of Sri Guru. Always there is some confusion, always some doubts. So that's why we are taking shelter to the lotus feet of God. So mercy is there. First we need this. Most important. If there is no Guru Kripa, then nothing is there. So first Guru Kripa, then practice. Which practice? What Guru will say. Maybe Baba says something. Maybe Baba says something to his disciples, to devotees, that you must do that. I start to compare with the scriptures. If scriptures say that, no, we should not. When Guru said this, we should not compare with anything. We must follow that. Because Guru said. Guru means heavy. Already we have heavy power with us. Guru Kripa. That is not light. Not small. Not short. It's really very big. Heavy. So already we have Guru Kripa. When we have Guru Kripa, we must go with all the advices. We must go with all the desire of Sri Guru. When Guru says something, do that. That means I have to do this. It is fixed for me. When Guru advised me something, what he advised me, he didn't advise to other. Why me? Because I am for that. We must follow. We should not judge it, or we should not compare with, or we should not just search if it is according to scripture or not. No. So first Guru Kripa, then what Guru will say? We must follow by mind, by speech, and physically. Kaya Vakya. Then we can attain something. So what it is there in the heart of all the near associates of Sri Krishna and Srimati Radharani, when by Guru Kripa that lobha, greed will appear, oh, I have such mood. By Guru Kripa, in my heart it's developed, maybe friendly mood, okay? I should follow Sridham, Sudham, Dham, Sudham. Maybe in my heart it's appeared, oh, Gopala, parental mood, Vatsalya. So, Nanda Baba, Maya, Sudha is there. And when that attachment of Jugal will appear, so we should follow Prajagopis. Srinath Pandit also said same things, isn't it? He said we should follow all the Prajagopis, all the footprints of Prajagopis. We cannot, we are not able to do that. Because our intelligence, our realization, our practice is not so high. But how much we can? In Hari Bhakti Vilas, at the end of Hari Bhakti Vilas, it is said, Sanatan Goswami Bhad, when he elaborated this Hari Bhakti Vilas, at the end, he described everything, all the rules, all the regulations, all the brothers, and everything in Hari Bhakti Vilas, he described. And at the end, he said, I just described everything. But how much you can follow that? According to your ability. At the beginning, we have to keep pressure ourselves. Because at the beginning, it will not appear automatically. The desire will not appear automatically. So that's why we have to do forcefully. Guru said, chant Mahamantra. At the beginning, okay, just do only 16 rounds. Char Granthi Naam. But 4 rounds is heavy for me. And Guru said 16 rounds. 4 rounds is heavy for me. And Gurudev said to me, advised me that you must chant 16 rounds. So that time, I have to force myself. Anyhow, I have to fulfill the desire of Sri Gurudev. Once I asked in Nidaidha, just after lecture, the devotees, they came to my room. So Dauji also was there, Sruti also was there. I asked to everyone, why you are chanting Mahamantra?
Yes.
Why you are chanting Mahamantra? Why? So some of them they said, okay, Harinam has so much power, so pray. So I said, I'm not on that stage to realize the power of Harinam. I'm very low level on the ground. Still I'm working on the ground. Now tell me, why you are chanting Mahamantra? Why you are chanting Harinam? I forgot who said first. I am chanting because Gurudev said. I am chanting Harinam because Gurudev said it. I ask, there is no other cause to attain prema, to attain bhakti. I have no desire other because I know I have nothing, I have no power, I have no ability. Gurudev said, chant Mahamantra as much as possible, so I am chanting. It is the right point. And right choice. What Gurudev said, I should follow. Without judging that. So, here, raga. What it is raga? It is said, raga mikam anusrita jasa raga nuchate. Which moved in the heart of all the Brajavasis who were very near to Srimati Radharani and Sri Govinda. So when we are starting to follow, to attain that mood, when we are starting to follow their footprints, that is Raganuga Bhakti. That's known as Raganuga. And what is Raga? It is bhajan, raganuga. And then what is raga? Ishte sarsiki nishta raga parama vishtata bhavet. What is swarasiki raga? Raga means attachment, love, prem. No, not prem. Because prem is so high. Raga means attachment, moha, bandhan, little bit bandhan. But what is swarasiki? In our this material life, we are enjoying. By the different senses, we are enjoying different things, is not? In material life, our eyes always searching some beauty, sundara. Always we want. We don't want to see anything vulgar, which is not really beautiful. We are searching always beauty. Oh, very beautiful flower. So we are going near. Our tongue always searching some tasty food. Ear always searching very beautiful, sweet voice. Isn't it? So, by different senses, it's very natural. How our eyes is always searching for beauty, ears searching for sweet voice, tongue searching for good foods, tasty foods. Same way, we have not to say to our eyes, search where is beautiful things. We have not to say to our tongue, love tasty foods. It's natural. It's coming naturally. Oh, it is not good taste. It's very bitter. Yes, it's sweet. So it's natural attachment. It's known as raga, natural attachment. But it is known as attachment. When that natural attachment will appear for Sri Krishna, Jugal, Srimati Radhara, that attachment known as raga. We have not to say our senses. We have not to say to our hands, do Krishna Puja, do Krishna Shiva. We have not to order to our food, go to Krishna temple. We have not to say to our eyes, get darshan of Krishna. when it will appear normally, naturally. Automatically, when our eyes only will search Krishna and Krishna devotees, when our mind always want Sangha, Bhakta Sangha, Vaishnava Sangha, when our hand always want to do seva of Sri Krishna and Krishna Bhakta, Vaishnava, that known as Raga. Tanmai ya bhagat bhakti shatro ragat mikadita. When it will merge with our heart and mind and everything, when we'll be absorbed in that mood, that mood, that bhakti known as ragatmika bhakti. So it is not so easy to develop such mood at the beginning. It will not happen, it will not appear. Why we are discussing this all external things? Because our topic is Vilapa Swanjali. Because this is very important to realize that mood of Tulasi Manjari. Why is he crying? Why is he offering that flowers, Anjali? To realize that mood, we must know that. So at the beginning, in the heart of sadhaka, that ragatmika bhakti will be not there. We have to develop it. But how it will develop? The question is there. How it will develop? It is not like fruit that just eat and it will grow. No. It is not food, just eat and got it. No, not that. So then, it is said, how it will appear, Jiva Goswami Pati said, to describe this mood of raga, sarasiki raga, ragatmika bhakti, in the commentary of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Grantha. He said that no, at the beginning, it will not be there. And it will not appear in the heart of sadhaka very easily. So what to do? Okay, we need some sangha. Bhakta sangha, Vaishnava sangha. Who already followed all the scriptures? Who followed the path of scriptures? It is clearly said, Jiva Goswami just said it. Who followed the scriptural path and attain by that practice, when one attains such a mood, we need kripa from them. When they describe that mood, about that mood. Because if I have no realization, self-realization, then I cannot describe. I can describe only to read in the books. But it will not touch other heart because it was not experienced. First I have to realize, then I can explain to other. Otherwise it will be not fruitful. Then my mind will be confused and to whom I will explain, describe, their mind also will be confused. Then both of us will go in different direction, not in Bhakti Bhattha. So it must be first experienced by that person to whom I'll take center, to whom I'll ask. So when he will describe from his realization, if I never taste Rasgulla, I'll never describe what is Rasgulla. Only to see, one can describe the taste of Rasgulla. What is that? But if we taste it, then after so many tastes of rasgulla, then I can explain something. Because that time already I loved rasgulla. And I explain with love. And I describe my experience and realization. So when one devotee, they are following the path of scriptural path, scriptures, and they attain that stage of raga, we must ask to them, when they describe their realization, why we are following Six Goswami's granthas? Why Vishwanath Chakravarti, he said, there is only granthas which is described by Six Goswamis. It's most important because they describe to us from their experience, from their realization. Not only by dry knowledge. Dry knowledge is very dangerous for our bhakti bhakti. We can ask such question which we have little bit realized. If the topic and content just out of my knowledge or experience, we should not ask because the answer will confuse our brain, buddhi, intelligence. We must go step by step, step by step, not to jump. What will happen if I will give one mathematics who is just studying in class 5 and I gave him class 12 mathematics? Maybe from teacher he will get this, but it will not be clear. It will not clear to him. Why? Because the steps, the middle steps are missing for him. So that is why we must go to them who has realization, experience in bhakti path. When they will describe to us from their realization, from their experience, then we can get something. Then our realization will start. So at the beginning it will not start. From such kinds of devotees when we listen, then lobha will appear, greed. Oh, it's really tested. When he just described his experience and realization, so it must be very tested. Then that lobha, that greed appeared, okay, I have to test it. I have to test it, like them. But that test from where it will come? So then, to whom I ask that question, to whom I got that experience knowledge, I'll ask to him. Okay, I want to test this. He'll show us the path. Okay, which mood in your heart appeared, you just follow them. If you have friendly mood, go to Krishna's friend. If you have servantal mood, go to Krishna's servant. If you have parental mood, go to his parents. And if you have beloved mood, so go to Krishna's beloveds. Follow. Aradha Bhagavan Brajesha Tanayam Staddhama Vrindavanam Ramya Kachit Upashana Braja Vadhu Vargena Sakalpita श्रीमद् भागवतम प्रमाणम अमरम प्रेम पुमर्थ महान श्रीमद् महाप्रभु मतमिदं तत्रादरण अपर सेम वर्ड्स ऑल्सो श्रीनाथ पंडित ही डिस्क्राइब टू अस रम्या काचित उपासना ब्रजवधु वर्गेण सकल्पिता यू मस्ट फॉलो देयर फुटप्रिंट्स इफ यू हैव बिलावल फुट गो टू देम व्हाई ही जस्ट मेंशन ओनली द गोपीज बिकॉज इट इज द हाईएस्ट फुट बट इन द बैकग्राउंड ऑल्सो इट इज सेड एज यू मूव यू फॉलो देम It is the conclusion of Srimad Mahaprabhu and Srimad Bhagavata Siddhanta. So then it will appear when that Raganuga Bhakti and Ragat Mika mood will appear in the heart of Sadhaka, then that attachment. For Srimati Radharani will appear above Sakhi Bhava. It is also said in five categories Sakhi. There is also two part. He just mentioned two part. Sambhaga Chatmika, all the Naikas, that means the beloved of Krishna, they have that sense, this mood. Sambhaga Chatmika. They have love for Krishna and tad bhavit chatmika. That is Sakhi mood. Sakhi mood means manjari mood. That is known as Sakhi bhav or manjari bhav. Because their ananda, their happiness is in the meeting of Nayaka and Nayika, that means Sri Krishna and Srimati Radha. When by their meeting they will get pleasure, that pleasure touches the heart of Manjaris. It is said that how much? 100 times, 1,000 times more than Srimati Radharani. When Krishna, he touches Srimati Radharani, she is getting pleasure by the touch of Krishna. But that pleasure, all the manjaris, they will get 100 times more than Srimati Radharani. Shatagunam adhikam. This word clearly said, Shatagunam adhikam. 100 times more than Srimati Radharani, they will get that pleasure, same pleasure. So they are very clear about their happiness, about their ananda. By their mathematics, they are very clear, very expert about their mathematics. If I'll go to Krishna direct, then I'll not get such pleasure. How much Srimati Radharani will praise, realize, we cannot. But when Srimati Radharani will get pleasure from Krishna by her mood, how much she will get pleasure? Will get 100 times more than Srimati Radharani. Who can enjoy and get pleasure from Krishna perfect? Only Srimati Radharani. Why? Because only she can attain the stage of Madanakha Mahabhava. Only she. So the manjaris, they are very clear about their calculation. No one can attain that stage. So if we are following, if we are serving Srimati Radharani, we'll get 100 times more pleasure than Srimati Radharani, the same. So why will we go to Krishna? We'll get 100 times more same pleasure than Srimati Radharani. So So that's why we are going to Srimati Radharani. They are very clear. Tad bhavichatmika. The sweetness, they are drinking the sweetness of their meeting. In one hand, the manjaris, they are getting pleasure of Srimati Radharani 100 times more than Srimati Radharani. And in other hand, they are drinking that sweetness. Which sweetness? Together. The together happiness. When Krishna is meeting Srimati Radharani and Srimati Radharani meeting Sri Krishna, so some together pleasure is appearing there. Self-pleasure is different and together, joint pleasure is different. So that sweetness is better. Then Krishna's mood. They are drinking that sweetness and they are getting pleasure of Srimati Radharani 100 times more than Srimati Radharani. That's why they are not going to Krishna. It's better for us. We are here, we are serving Srimati Radharani, we are getting 100% pleasure, 100% sukha, ananda from their meeting. So that is very different mood than all other sakis. Now, what is the mood of Tulasi Manjari, Raghunath Das Goswami? What is inside of that? In introduction, also it is important to know for us. So, what is the special mood of Raghunath Das Goswami, Tulasi Manjari, as a Manjari and as a sadhaka? Because I said, there is two. One is sadhaka, Raghunath Das Goswami, and at the same time there is Manjari, Tulasi Manjari, Rati Manjari. So what is the realization, what is the mood of them, Raghunath Das Goswami and Tulasi Manjari? We'll know, not today, tomorrow. Tomorrow meaning, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. One. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Nitai Gaur Hare Hare. Kirtan, more Kirtan, okay?
Good.
राधे
राधे राधे राधे
जय राधे 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 जय राधे राधे राधे
राधे राधे राधे जय राधे राधे
राधे राधे जय राधे राधे राधे
राधे राधे राधे जय राधे राधे राधे
जय राधे 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 जय राधे राधे राधे
राधे राधे राधे जय राधे राधे राधे
जय राधे 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 जय राधे राधे राधे
राधे राधे
Yeah.